What's up? This is The Zone. I'm one of your hosts for tonight, Michael Hairston, and this funny-looking dude sitting next to me is Mike Wood. How you doing?
Yeah, we're wasting no time at all. We're going to jump right into it, and Larry's telling us what's happening.
What's up, Mike? Hey, we're about to continue our series on sex in young America. And how does the third installment, third deposit, whatever you want to call it, on how Virginia is being redefined by the media and the culture as a whole. But before we jump into that little thing, let's Miss Becca Pruitt-Denny give us our first lineup.
Larry, we have PAX 217, Audio A, Cross Movement, and a new group called Vena on the show tonight. Of course, our license report is later on in the show, and we have all kinds of good stuff, but you got to stay tuned and watch. Michael, what video do you want to see first?
All right, Becca, let's get this party started with Audio Adrenaline with Get Down here on The Zone.
Life is sweet, lives are wasted, humble, lessons left untasted. You can't live your life to please yourself, yeah. That's a tip from my mistake, exactly what it doesn't take.
Hey, this is Adam. That was Audio Adrenaline with Get Down here in The Zone. Now we're going to hand it over to Becca.
Thanks, Adam. We are continuing our series on sex in young America, and this week it's on virginity. We're trying to redefine it. I'm talking with Josh in India. Now, Josh, you were talking to me about sex and virginity. Can you define virginity for me?
Virginity is the act of not having sex. This includes saving yourself for marriage, saving yourself for your spouse, and so you can someday have sex with that person and it not be a sin.
All right, so you think most teens feel the same way, that you can do anything and everything except for the actual act of intercourse and still be a virgin?
They believe anything goes. They believe you can do other things beyond sex and still be considered a virgin.
Wow, okay. How about you, India? Can you give me your definition of virginity?
I agree with Josh. It's the act of not giving yourself away at the wrong time.
Are we just talking about sex here or more?
It's more than just intercourse. It's anything to oral sex and on.
Okay. And how you were talking to me earlier about schools, what it means to be a virgin in school nowadays.
As far as school goes, it's a common topic for kids today to talk about sex. If you're a virgin, you wouldn't be considered to be cool because you couldn't be in the everyday common conversation about what that person did the night before.
That's depressing. I mean, I think the whole purpose of being a virgin is saving yourself, like you guys said. It's to share something, though, special and intimate with only one person. I mean, not everyone can say that. And if you can, that's awesome. I mean, if you're going around doing physical things with a lot of different people, it's not quite so intimate or special. But we're going to talk more about virginity later on. But first, Larry gives us our next video.
All right, Becca. Hey, did y'all hear those answers? Y'all can't tell me them answers went no doubt deep. You don't say they Generation X, Generation Next. I'm talking about straight for Jesus, though. Did you hear that wisdom and knowledge for that type of age? Anyway, let me get out my little box. But let me go on with this next group coming up here. You can check out their soundtrack on the motion picture, Extreme Days. Here's PAX 217 with AM, No Doubt, in the Zone.
Simple. No running, no screaming, no splashing. In other words, you get me wet, I get you wet.
Are you among the masses? And you will never pass us. Are you among the masses? Are you among the masses? And you will never pass us. Woke up today in the places made of high. Had the revelation while I'm waiting in line. I'm a picture of your face back across the screen. I'm gonna get the sinking to 17. Stare at me, I can't forget a set of eyes. A window to your thoughts, what I like to analyze. So don't be surprised when I memorize you in a crowd. We the people got purpose in it now.
Movement with their new video up later, but right now I'm gonna take a break, so keep locked in on the Zone.
Yeah, we're doing big things here on The Zone, having fun as always. But before I tell you what we got coming up next, I want to tell you something right now. If you want to be on this show and have all the fun that our crowd is having here today, I want you to run, not walk, to your phone. Dial 513-221-4888. Find out how you can get on The Zone and get a whole bunch of free stuff, including food. Hey, if for those of you who like surfing the web and being on the computer and all, this is what I want you to do. Check us out, surfthezone.com. Even send us your video requests. Can't guarantee that we play them, but go ahead and send them to us anyway. Right now, we got another group coming up. My personal favorite, boy, I get geeked every time I hear them. This Cross Movement with... What y'all know about this? Come on, do it right.
The hip-hop song of the year is... If It Ain't Nasty, It Ain't Right.
By Ice Lane.
What you know about this? When you seek his heart and mind, you start to find faith in the gospel, there's your gift, treasure it. Watch out for those heretics to make God out to be this genie in a bottle, like the Christina at the lamp of hit. Read and tears, there's the script. Be aware of it, when the scripture hits your right, it'll switch your plot. That's how you know you're out of darkness and into light.
This beat is hot, now I gotta heat the spot. Feed the flock and pray that non-believers stop. We grow together both weed and crop, so you need to take heed to the seed I drop. Jesus, up in every piece I drop. Time's running out, so we gotta beat the clock. Peep it out, cause he is more weed a lot. You need the pot, you know that you need to stop. You got more dough than a pizza shop. Showing all the goals heat you got. You keep a fox in the front seat of the Jeep you got. And you keep it locked. Won't go to church till your Easter shop. New suit and shoes in the Easter top. People stop and say, yo, he's the shot. But God says, no, he's not. God is known to police the block. He's the cop that ain't afraid to squeeze the clock.
But he really loves me a lot.
You don't know what his D's is or what his D's is not. You face the place where eternity is hot. I'm not afraid to say hell, some need the shot. His wrath is laser sharp. I see the dot. Trust him before you breathe and stop.
Before I thank anybody, I'd like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because without him...
What you know about this? You don't know me, so no, you don't know me. 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 What you know about this? Can't get it, yeah, you know one another.
The text, though we wish men were X, sin's hex, mutates into death effects. We sex gun Lex and we love the vex. Evil's got us wide open like Nasonex. And for some, this life's like a major bet. They put all the chips up on a major set. But when they lose to the one with the major flex, ain't nothing left but the major dad. Yet it's more than a loss of pay. Everybody wanna floss and play. Guzzle Cavassier, somebody better check God's dossier. He ain't accepting everything you wanna toss away. Cause you love the game, want the fame, not the blame, not the shame, not the pain, not the flame. But it's all in vain, cause even demons know his name, big boy.
You know his name, but do you really know why he came for your game's up? I think you better find out. Take a pause for the calls while you're playing. Call a timeout. Well, you ought to check in with the coaching staff. Running plays and don't know the half. Seeming like you're making up your own meaning. Like you're playing a game of golden bass. Taking common grace. Look at the time you waste. I know you want to see your shining face, but you're separated by time and space. Till Jesus Christ came and conquered our place. And took the cross, took a loss, tasted death and shook it off. Rose in three, said roll with me like a rotary. Now look at y'all, making noise with crazy joy. Like young bucks when they play with toys. Predestined sent way back when, man, we go back like lazy boys. But all to him and none to me was sin by sin like 1, 2, 3. He healed me, filled me, saved me, gave me life abundantly.
What you know about this? You don't know me, so no, you don't know me.
But you don't know me.
No, you don't know me.
Trust me.
No, you don't know me.
What you know about this?
We ain't no man.
Yeah, yeah, you know one another.
Ain't Christ no man.
Yeah, yeah, you can know.
What you know about this?
You know what? I can't accept this award in Jesus' name. Because it's a misrepresentation of who he is.
And that was a cross movement here on The Zone. And we're going to get right back into our topic about virginity. And we heard India's definition. We heard Josh's definition. We know Bill Clinton's definition. And throughout the ages, definitions are getting more and more skewed with our culture becoming more and more relativistic. Something like that. But Becca's going to find out the real definition right now in the Live Zone Report. So watch this.
This special Live Zone is the third of five in our series on sex and young America. Stay tuned at the end of the segment for information on how you can learn more on this series. Viewer discretion is advised.
You have a sexually transmitted disease.
What?
You contracted gonorrhea.
Wait, but that's impossible. I've never even had sex. I'm a virgin.
What about oral sex?
That doesn't count.
If you can get a sexually transmitted disease from it, then wouldn't that act be considered sex? So how do you define virginity? And is it even important anymore?
I think the term virginity, if you look at it by the letter of the law, like, you know, I haven't actually had someone inside me. So, you know, that's like, I'm still a virgin.
Yeah, the textbook definition of a virgin is someone who has not had sexual intercourse.
I've met people who said that they're virgins because they actually haven't had penetration or whatnot, but then they say they've had oral sex, and that's basically the same thing.
In high school, I thought that not having sex was just not having intercourse.
I've heard that the actual definition is full sexual intercourse and not oral.
I think oral sex was just something that was created like when girls and guys mess around when they're trying to stay away from having sex.
Oh, definitely teenagers probably think, if I have oral sex, I'm still a virgin. I mean, if you think about it, I mean, you're not actually having intercourse, so they would think, oh, I'm still a virgin.
The penis enters the vagina, that is having sex.
Touching isn't having sex. You can definitely both get off by touching each other just as much, you know? You just gotta be good at it.
If y'all are coming in contact with each other, genitals and stuff, that's sex to me. Seriously, it's sex to me.
If you're gonna call oral sex having sex and losing purity, you might as well call giving a hand job or banging someone the same or anything like that. Anything that turns someone on.
It might not be intercourse, but it's still, like, I still look at it as a form of sex.
My mom was talking to me and she asked me if I thought that oral sex was really sex, and I was like, well, no, I don't think it is. And she said, like, surprisingly, it really is.
Most people feel that oral sex is not quite going as far as real sex. And a lot of people still believe the myth that you won't get STDs from doing oral sex, and you can't get pregnant, so it feels like it's less of a risk factor for most people.
I mean, you can get sexually transmitted disease by having oral sex, and teenagers probably think, oh, if I have oral sex, nothing's gonna happen. I mean, I'm not really having sex. I can't get pregnant or anything, but there's a lot of serious consequences.
Impurity is not easy by any means. Like, it's so easy. It's so easy to just, you know, just do it. Just please your boyfriend, or, you know, however people put it, you know. It's so easy, and then purity is so hard.
So purity and virginity go hand in hand.
Yeah. And once you've given part of it away, it's like giving the whole thing away, whether it's in your heart or in your mind. I mean, you've given away. It's more than just the physical part.
For me physically, yes, I'm a virgin. But for my mind, I wish I could say that I am, but I'm not.
I went to youth group all the way through high school, so I would go on Wednesday and hear this message of moral purity, and I would think, okay, I want that so bad. And then I would hang out with my boyfriend, and I would feel seriously guilty for being sexually active with him.
You'd meet a guy, you know, he was cute, you had a good time together. You'd go out, he'd buy you dinner, and he'd treat you so nice, you know, and you're just, that was the thing you would do. You would go home or wherever, and, you know, you would pay him back. You would go down on him, or, you know, like, you know, vice versa. And I just, you know, it wasn't like this big, like, moral issue to me, and so it's only by the grace of God that I'm still a virgin.
You know, if a guy asked you to give him a blowjob, then be like, yeah, sure, I want to be loved, you know? I want to feel like I'm appreciated. You know, maybe if I do this, then he will love me.
That purity, that innocence, I had that taken away from me when I was 7 years old. And a friend of mine has a sticker on her car that reads, "Pornography rapes the mind." Now, you don't think to tell a seven-year-old that these things are bad, that to stay away from it But I think if someone had told me in a way that I could understand, it would have changed my life. But the point I want to make about that is you can change. If you've had that taken away from you, if you've, for whatever reason, had your virginity taken away from you, had your purity taken away from you, your innocence, it's the hardest thing in the entire world. I know, I've been there. But you can change, and the only way that you can change is through God. And that, I mean, it sounds cliche, but if it hadn't been for God and my family, I wouldn't even be where I am today.
When I stand on that altar before my wife, am I going to be proud of the gift that I have to present to her, the gift being my purity?
The point of saving your virginity is so that you can have a special, strong bond with your spouse, and only your spouse. And remember, the Lord looks at your heart. It's not about just having a pure body, but also a pure mind. And God can give you that, no matter what you've done in the past.
Next week on Sex and Young America, we'll explore internet pornography. Sex and Young America is part of a larger series and is now available from the National Coalition for the Protection of Children and Families. For more information on how you can obtain a copy of Sex and Young America, please visit sexandyoungamerica.com or call 513-521-6227.
Now tuned in, we're talking about Sex and Young America, and I'm telling you, it's a very interesting topic, so you want to stay locked into this, no doubt. I'm sitting here with Renee and Laura, and we were talking about earlier about what's the difference between purity and virginity. So Miss Renee, break it down for us.
Well, virginity to me is the actual concept of abstaining from sex or any sexual things, and purity to me reminds me of the scripture verse, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Whereas you have to keep your mind, your body, and your spirit pure at all times.
Well, that's a good scripture, no doubt. And Miss Laura, now you tell me, why is purity more important, no doubt, than virginity?
Purity is more important than virginity because purity follows you throughout your life. And if you're pure and you have purity in your heart and you follow God's, more than likely if you have one, you'll have the other. Therefore, it's more important to have that one.
Well, so you're saying that purity is a lifestyle. Interesting. Well, as you can see, now I'm telling you, these ladies are sharp, and ladies, thank you very much. As you can see, now purity is, like I said, it's a lifestyle, day by day, hour by hour. So, understand that it's not overnight. It's going to take some time. So, without further ado, Miss Becca, what's up?
Thank you, Larry. We have to take a little bitty break now, but we will be back right here.
In the zone!
On the heezy for sheezy, my girl just stepped on my mic cord, man, so I'm smacking myself in the face, but that's a lot of crazy antics we got going on here. It's a lot of fun. We'll see you next week here on The Zone, right?